The Asian Development Bank slashes its 2020 growth forecast for the Philippine economy to way below government's targets. As Warren de Guzman reports, the country's growth outlook rests on the success of its vaccination program.
The Asian Development Bank and Fitch Ratings have lowered their growth outlooks for the Philippines this year. The Asian Development Bank lowered its forecast to at least 4.5% from its 6.5% forecast in December 2020. ADB Country Director for the Philippines, Kelly Bird, says both the upside and downside risks to growth are linked to the Philippines' vaccination program.
Wealthy nations have stockpiled vaccines, and that can create further delays in the rollout of the vaccination program, affecting the Philippines and other developing member countries. When we expect larger volumes to come, most likely from June onwards, I think the Philippines will be in a good situation to be able to scale up vaccinations on a daily basis.
Socioeconomic Planning Secretary Carl Chua earlier said it's too early to tell the impact of the COVID-19 spike on growth.
We have a target of 6.5 to 7.5% this year. And we are still early in the year, I think, to make changes.
The economic team is also hoping the vaccination program will pave the way for a quicker economic recovery. Vaccination sites around Metro Manila, including Quezon City, are sprouting. Homeowners Association and commercial centers are coordinating with LGUs to vaccinate as many people in their areas as possible, but they need more vaccine doses.
We're ready. We have all our volunteers. Puro homeowners yan, doctors and non-doctors, na sila yung nag-offer ng service nila, ng oras nila.
Kung sino man ng mag-arte-arte pa, Diyos ko, magkatusok nga lang. That's the biggest na magawa mo. The first, isa pa, kung hindi nagpatusok ang maraming tao, paano tayo magkakaroon ng herd immunity kung tawagin, di ba?
The ADB, however, warns the pandemic could have some long-term effects. Bird notes disruptions in training and education may have made many Filipinos less hireable, and some of the jobs recently created, as cited by Secretary Chua, aren't as stable as those that were lost in 2020.
The concern for us is that the employment that's been generated is in the informal sector, so it's self-employment or those who are working for self-employed. And these are generally the less stable employment activities. You know, the earnings are unstable. They're not always covered by the social system, for example. They don't generally have access to skills training. It's in the informal sector, so they are lower quality jobs. And that's the concern, that lower quality jobs are being created, not the quality jobs. We estimated that poverty would probably reach around 20% this year. But we do expect, once the economy starts opening further, and given the government's social assistance programs, we do expect those poverty numbers to start to decline.
A poverty incidence of 20% could mean the total number of poor Filipinos increased by around 4 million from the 17.7 million total hit in 2018, when the Duterte administration managed to cut poverty incidence to 16.7%. But Chua is confident they can still bring down the poverty rate to 14% by 2022 through the job creation and other multiplier effects of the build infrastructure push and the safe reopening of the Philippine economy. Warren de Guzman, ABS-CBN News.